This video introduces you to the concept of Ito lemma. Now, Ito lemma is the essential calculus approach for stochastic differential equations. And in this video, I will focus on the scalar case. Now, let xt be the solution to the following Ito SDE. We have a drift part f of xt. We have a conditional volatility part, g of xt, and we have a Brownian innovation, dwt. Now, let the function u be a function of xt and of t. And the output to that function is what we denote as yt. So yt can be written as simply the output of the u function that takes t and xt as an input. Now, we also assume that the u function is sufficiently smooth so that we can place the first and the second derivative with regard to x, and we can also differentiate u with regard to time. These are the two smoothness conditions. Now, if that holds, then the dynamic of yt coincides with an Ito SDE itself. Now, one could write that compactly as the following expression here, where dyt is a of u dt plus l1 u dwt. Now that's a bit of a messy notation, but I'm using it here to keep the video really general. Now the a of u is simply short form for the following longer expression. You take the first derivative of u with regard to time, you add the first derivative of u with regard to x times the drift of x, which is f of x. And then, importantly, you add half the second derivative of u with regard to x times the variance, the conditional variance of x. And the L1 u is also just short form for the first derivative of u with regard to x times the conditional volatility of x. So that previous let then statement is really just the famous lemma of Professor Ito, which is usually just called Ito lemma. Now in words, as I've said before, but I want to summarize it again since it's so important, it says that if the input to a function follows an Ito SDE, then the output to a sufficiently smooth function follows also an Ito SDE. And the Ito rule looks very much like a standard ordinary calculus rule. So if you look carefully at these formulas, you note that the key difference to the chain rule from ordinary calculus is that additional term in the drift of y, that 1/2 second derivative of u with regard to x square times the variance, the conditional variance of x. Now the respective Ito integral representation of yt looks as follows. So last not least, language wise, that strange looking term au is also called the generator of an Ito process U.